When they dipped my head, then I came up shiny and laid down my burden. Found out about love in the back of my Impala where they laid my grandfather to. And by the river, now we're black folk together at the Sunday services through. How the river runs through the ocean.
Making music by myself and writing. I had a manager at that time, Larry Fernandez, and then he knew somebody in Rhode Island by the name of T.O. So we all linked together and we started making music, getting a catalog together. You know, we start taking trips to New York, and, you know, it was a whole thing of getting to KG, and he had worked with Jaheim, and a lot of people know him from working with Next and Coffee Brown and groups of that nature. So KG liked my voice in such a way that he put me on the beginning of the movie, The Cookout, with the record called Family Reunion. And, you know, ever since, and I was unsigned then. So it had taken quite a few years to really get to that point. But, you know, we started taking meetings with record labels. This was around the time that Jay-Z was at Def Jam. We went over to Def Jam to meet with Jay-Z and Tata. We left there, went to Virgin. That was when Jermaine Dupri was there. Had a meeting with him, a strong meeting. Before we left New York and headed back to Boston, they wanted to squeeze in one more meeting with Sony, and we met with Chad Elliott and KP over there. We played them our catalog of music, and they said, don't take it anywhere else. So about a month after that, we were signed with Sony. I mean, in my experience, I would say it should be called business music. You are looked at as an entity. You are somebody that can make money for this company. And that's just the bottom line. That's the cut and dry of it. And you have to go in with a business mind. This industry has made me grow some thick skin. I mean, because it's like I said, it's full of ups and downs. And for the young artists out there, you know, there might be quite a few no's, but if you don't quit and keep persevering and keep working and keep the right people around you, you know, it's that one yes that will change your entire life. I mean, I was staying in a cold one-room studio apartment with no food, no money. You know, I would scrounge up as much as I could, Angel, from week to week, get a loaf of bread, maybe a dozen eggs and this and that and water. And, you know, it was sleeping in cars to try to get back and forth to New York, being able to sleep in the car, not being able to get a hotel room, but just scrounging enough. And, you know, it was a rough time. It was really rough. But now, you know, I look back on it and I appreciate where I'm at right now. It's a tremendous blessing to be able to do what I'm doing for a living. And, you know, there's been some really tough times. You know, it's just all about just believing in your path and what God has laid out for you and what you have to do for yourself to be able to be successful. I want people, when they speak of me, to say he had nothing but good records, nothing but great records. People still saying that 30 years from now. So as long as I can have that and leave the industry with that, then I'm happy. Hey, what's shaking, y'all? This is Noel Gourdin, and when I'm online, I'm listening to your 15 Minutes Radio.